Opening tip. It is chased down, and it is controlled by Texas Southern.
Rob, we are anticipating a very intense game. Already we have a charge drawn here by Alexis Parker, who's been a great defender, a great scorer for Prairie View, and the fact that she knows where to put her body to draw that charge is a good start to this game.
And, of course, committing the foul was Morgan Simmons. By the way, taking a look at the starting lineups for these two squads, we will take a look first at the visitors from Prairie View A&M. Jeanette Jackson, the 5'7 senior out of Las Vegas, Nevada, as it is an air ball launched by Shanice Stevens. She is the 5'9 senior from Port Lucie. Alexis Parker, who just took the charge. 5'10 sophomore from Savannah, Georgia, Shamaya Brooks. Double-double extraordinaire is Shamira Brooks. She will block shots, she will get rebounds, and she will give you extra opportunities. And she's in that starting lineup as well for Prairie View. Early lead belongs to the home team in this one. Fadeaway will not fall, but again, you got a rebound and another opportunity. Parker tried the two-pointer, the long two, standing just inside the arc. Rebound grabbed, and Jackson will bring it inside, try to tie it up. She does, and just might have an opportunity to break the early tie.
Jeanette Jackson is fearless. She always, anytime she penetrates, is looking to score. Either she's scoring or she's getting fouled. That's her mentality. And this game is so intense, and it has always been intense, and you can see by the air ball that was shot by Stevens, just getting those pre-game jitters out, getting those early jitters out so that she can be effective. Hopefully she gets her feet onto her soon.
Prairie View grabbing the lead. And you gotta walk. And we will go back to the Prairie View end of the floor.
Brianna Sidney should have took that shot instead of passing it to Simmons. She was in the paint already. That's a high percentage shot. Whenever you're that close, you need to take it.
Texas Southern has got these five. Starting this one, the 5'9 junior, Brianna Sidney. We talked about her in pregame. She is a Brooklyn, New York product and junior. Morgan Simmons, the 6'1 senior out of Texas. Sarah Williams at 5'5, a senior from Virginia. And you've got Ashley Ferguson, the 6'2 sophomore from Arlington, Texas. And you go all the way to Denver, Colorado to get Alexis Johnson, who is a 6'2 sophomore. Early 3-2 advantage as the toss goes to Sydney. A bump as Alexis Johnson had the round ball, and they again call her for the walk. If I can go ahead and predict that if Alexa Johnson gets double digits, they win. They've done it 6 times out of 7 this year.
That usually is how it is. But this game between Prairie View and TSU is always so unpredictable. The last time these two teams came together, it came down to the wire, and senior Jeanette Jackson hit 2 free throws to win the game. So as long as Alexis Johnson and Jeanette Jackson show up, we have a good ball game.
Miracle Davis in the lineup and committing to personal. Miracle Davis is a 5'9 senior. Tulsa, Oklahoma is where she's from. Played some JUCO ball at Allen Community College.
Yeah, Miracle Davis has done some great things for TSU. She averages 3.1 assists. She loves to share the ball, and that's third highest in the conference.
Put in play to the big lady Brooks. Brooks can't hang on, going the other way. It is Miracle Davis. Whips it inside off the glass. Count the bucket for Brianna Sidney.
One thing that both of these teams have to remember is that this is a very intense game. Nothing is going to come easy. So when you go to the, when you're getting a pass, you have to meet that pass in order to make sure that you secure it.
One and done on the Prairie View end. Williams lost it, and Stevens comes up with it. And off to Jackson. 17 points per outing for Jackson. We mentioned earlier, 11 times she's gone over 20. She has started every game this year for Prairie View. Spin move off the glass was the intention, but it never got to the glass from Alexis Parker.
That was a great block by Alexis Johnson, using those long arms and her athleticism to get that.
Three-pointer Alexis Johnson drops it in.
Wow, Alexis Johnson is such a great shooter. She shoots 40% from the three-point line, and she's built like a post player. She just got a block on the defensive end and came down and scored her second basket on the offensive end. She usually averages 12.6 points, and she is well on her way to doing that.
I mentioned that Jackson has started every ball game this year for Prairie View A&M, the only other Lady Panther to do so. As Stevens brought it inside, went out of bounds off Stevens. The only other Lady Panther that started 21 straight. Asha Hampton Finch, the 6'3 senior out of San Antonio. And there was a timeout on the floor, and with the timeout, we do the same. Take a break. Beginning to feel H&PE Center on the campus of Texas Southern.
Toyota SWAC Basketball Tournament in Houston, Texas. 5 days of nonstop action, and it all goes down March 10th through the 14th. The SWAC is driven by passion and motivated by pride, because in the SWAC, history will be made. We do it for the love of the game. Visit www.swachoops.org.
There are some moments you spend your life preparing for. Not to prove them wrong, but yourself right. So you work harder, drive stronger, and before you know it, you didn't just beat the game.
Who is that?
Don't know, but he's going places.
You changed it.
Hey, son, ready for the interview?
I got this.
Introducing the 2014 Next Generation Corolla. Toyota, let's go places.
Center is already electric, and the longer we get into the ball game, the more so it will begin and become. As Chelsea Rosser, a 5'8 junior from Tallahassee, Florida, checks into the lineup for Prairie View A&M after the timeout.
Chelsea Rosser will be key for them in her substitution with hitting these outside shots. She's usually 32% from the three-point line, so hopefully she can contribute that tonight.
Diamondisha Sofas, a 5'5 junior from Houston, Texas, put into the lineup. And she's got it out front. Thought about the three. How about the three from the right side? The bucket counts. And Texas Southern benefiting.
Brianna Sidney, as Prairie View, you have to understand who are the key players and who are the players to pay particular attention to. And Brianna Sidney is one of those players, shooting 41% from the three-point line. If she's open, she will most likely hit that.
Almost getting the steal with Sidney, as a matter of fact, right on cue. As you were chit-chatting about Sidney, she was producing defensively instead of offensively. Rosa off with a shot. Up is Parker with the rebound, trying to get the shot off. Instead, there is a jump ball, and the possession arrows got us heading to the Tiger end of the floor.
One thing that Coach Perry mentioned about Brianna Sidney is that she feels that she hasn't had her breakout game yet. Last year versus Prairie View, she scored 29 points, causing them to be victorious. And even though she's been performing very well this season, Coach Perry still expects so much out of her. So each day she steps up and tries to show what she can do.
Nice move inside, Jeanette Jackson. Lob down the floor and is off the fingertips of Morgan Simmons.
Jeanette Jackson so far has been the only player to score for Prairie View. If they want to win this game, everybody's going to have to contribute. They have so many scores that when Jeanette Jackson, when she goes cold, they need to step up.
Jackson, shot misses, and we've got another jump ball. And we will again go to the Tiger end of the floor. SWAC Digital Network here in Houston, Texas. We were just on the other side of Houston a couple of weeks ago when Prairie View played host to Grambling State in that one. Jeanette Jackson shined, but she had some others who did shining as well, and that is in particular Shamira Brooks. Brooks had herself another double-double.
Yes, Shamira Big Body Brooks. She's actually leading the team in double-doubles, having six on the season already. And as a post player, that is a really big deal. Hopefully she can get her going when they get back in the game together, because their chemistry is amazing on the court.
Jackson charged with a foul. That will be the first Prairie View foul. Brought in from the baseline by Miracle Davis. Texas Southern is dropping in the threes. Miracle Davis with the third three already in the first half.
And this is to be expected. Texas Southern is the number one, has the number one scoring offense in the SWAC, and as well as scoring margin. So they score more than any team.
And a collision between a panther and a tiger. I guess that would be a, well, I can't go cheesy on you, because, you know, James is kind of our cheeseometer, and I was about to say we had a kitty crash, but he would have flagged me on that one. But we had some bodies run into one another, so it is brought in from the far sidelines.
Alexis Johnson took a little time getting up on that too, grabbing her shoulder, but she seems to be all right.
Hampton Finch from the elbow. Texas Southern will take it the other way. Asking for it on the opposite end is Tony Keedle. Back it will go off the glass. Excellent play as Ferguson gets two.
One thing about Texas Southern is that they love to share the ball. They play together more than any team. They average about 13 assists per game. So Prairie View needs to capitalize on that, making sure that their defense is tight and not allowing easy passes. That was great ball movement and passing by TSU.
Hampton Fitch sets the screen. Jackson goes the other way, lobs towards the hoop. Knew she was drawing the foul, and if she just got lucky and dropped it in, then might shoot for three, but instead she will be heading to the line and at best shoot for two.
Yes, she needed a little more arch on that shot, but I'm sure she's not complaining, because Jeanette Jackson, she's from Las Vegas, Nevada, and she's averaging 78% from the free throw line.
1,500 points in her career. As a matter of fact, Prairie View A&M, on both the ladies' side and the men's side, brings some 1,000-plus scores to the table. And you've got Jackson for the ladies and Montrell Scott for the men.
And that is a hard task. I don't know if people understand how difficult it is to score over 1,000 points. And she still has a lot of play left.
Davis bringing it to the elbow, brought it into the paint, off the glass, maybe a little off balance, but you can miss those kind of things when Ferguson is there for the putback.
Yeah, Ferguson uses her body, and she goes ahead and makes that contact first in order to obtain the rebound. Prairie View has to play better defense. Their defense is real sloppy right now. They need to find the defender and box out, or else they'll continue to get rebound on and score it on.
Brooks, who has been pretty quiet, got the rebound, but then walked with it before being able to put it up and in. There is a timeout on the floor, 12:32 left to play. Half number one. The double-digit lead belongs to the Lady Tigers.
There are some moments you spend your life preparing for. Not to prove them wrong, but yourself right. So you work harder, drive stronger, and before you know it, you didn't just beat the game.
Who is that? Don't know. But he's going places.
You changed it.
Hey, son, ready for the interview?
I got this.
Introducing the 2014 Next Generation Corolla. Toyota, let's go places.
Timeout asked for by Prairie View A&M. A little concerned is head coach Dawn Brown, with Texas Southern grabbing the 10-point lead early. It's not panic time, but it is time to get a bit concerned.
Right. When a team goes on a run like that, it's important for the coach to recognize that, call the timeout, just to make sure her troops are still together on one page.
There again, you've got points from Ashley Ferguson.
and another assist, something that Texas Southern does very well.
We talked about in the pregame that, yeah, we've got the Stars. We've got Jackson for Prairie View A&M. We've got Sydney for Texas Southern, but more than likely somebody else would shine for both. And right now it's Ashley Ferguson for Texas Southern. Skims the rim from Sophus. Save it in the hands of Stevens. Pull up Jay from the stripe. Dips in and out. Brooks has got it and puts it in.
TSU has to find Shamiah Brooks. She leads the conference in offensive rebounding. So she's looking for that ball, and she's looking to put it right back up.
Tony Cheadle, the 6-foot junior from Midwest City, Oklahoma, in the lineup. Giving it to Dana Jones, the 6-1 junior from Mississippi. It is brought inside. And Brianna Sidney will get fouled.
I love Brianna Sidney's game. She's just fearless. When she penetrates, similar to Jeanette Jackson, they look to score. Either you're going to foul them or they're going to score. That's the mentality that they have, and that's a wonderful mentality to have.
Another look. And just a little bit of the Stevens body. We've got on Brianna Sidney. Timeout on the floor. It is the media timeout, so we're the media. We'll take a break with Texas Southern leading.
Welcome to Texas Southern University. Our home is Houston. We are a premier urban university with distinctive undergraduate and graduate programs, innovative research, artistic excellence, and athletic tradition. We are building legends. Your future begins at TSU now.
Today's SWAC Digital Network broadcast brought to you by Toyota. Also, our coverage here from Houston, Texas, compliments of the Home Depot. Russell Athletics making coverage as possible as well. And, of course, Nike. Thanks so much to all of our sponsors, Coca-Cola included, for making coverage possible. Sydney's shot, catch of the front part of the rim, wouldn't roll over though, it rolls out.
Brianna Sidney, she's a junior from Brooklyn, New York. And she averages 84% from the free throw line. She leads the conference in free throw percentage.
Maybe a little unnerved in this one, missed them both. Parker bringing it the other way.
It seems Tony Cheadle got a piece of that to send it out of bounds.
So that means Parker and company will still have possession. They'll bring it in from the baseline. First of two, the men play next. Robert Williamson, Gate Werema on this one, and Van Panaway joins us for the men's game.
Speaking with Coach Don Brown earlier, she mentioned that the keys to winning tonight's game was to play team basketball and share the ball. That's one thing that Prairie View is struggling with right now. Jeanette Jackson does not have an outlet, and it seems that if she's not scoring, no one else is moving. In order to get out of that, they need to move and take shots.
Shamiah Brooks at 6'4", really doesn't look that many people eye to eye, but tried to bring it inside, and Kiana Vines denied her the opportunity, but right back comes Prairie View and puts two on the board to make it a 19-11 game.
Well, one great thing about tonight's matchup is that these teams match up so well. The post players, you have about six players who are over 6 feet on both teams. And as well as guards, you have scoring guards on both teams. So it's not going to be an easy night for anybody. The posts have to bang and the guards have to produce.
And in this particular case, a guard gets the rebound. It's Jackson coming down with the rebound. Hand Hampton Finch doesn't look comfortable. You know, the Bigs don't like dribbling the ball. Tried to get it over to Brooks, who just tipped away. Winds up in the hands of Miracle Davis.
That was a really bad pass. Shamiah Brooks posted and showed for the ball. And after she moved, that's when the pass came to her. If you're going to do a post-entry pass, you have to recognize when the player is open.
Shot misses by Vines, but Brooks got her. Why is it they are both listed at 6'4", but Vines looks larger than Brooks? She looks like she's got an inch or two on her.
She does. But the great thing about her, she knows how to use her body well. She drops that baseline and turns to the middle for a shot, and that's a high percentage shot. That's great, smart basketball IQ. Kiana Vines. She is a 6'4 junior from Oxnard, California. She averages 67% from the free throw line.
Monty Cavs has checked into the lineup. She's a 5'9 junior from Phoenix, Arizona. Also, Chelsea Roser, who had gone out, is back in. Vines a 1-for-2 trip at the stripe. Jackson, she's hammered.
That was a really hard foul. Jeanette Jackson went down hard, but she is so resilient, and she pops right back up.
One thing you can certainly say about Jackson, and obviously there are several things you can say about her, including that she's just got such a prowess at scoring, but her willingness to take on the big bodies.
She is fearless. Whenever she penetrates, as you can see right there, she just tries to go over the defense. And if you don't have position, all you can do is foul.
Tony Cheadle checking back into the lineup.
Jeanette Jackson once again scoring with her 78% from the free throw line.
Sydney's been relatively quiet of late as Sarah Williams brings it out front.
The good thing about Texas Southern is that they play basketball. They pace themselves, which is usually a good thing. Hopefully they don't get too comfortable and too lackadaisical, because that's when mistakes like that happen.
You played in this rivalry before, many times before, as a matter of fact. What makes this game, even aside from the rankings, the conference standings, which find one at the top, Texas Southern, and one nearby, Prairie View A&M, but what makes this so special?
I think that just because the schools are so similar, not only is it a rivalry for basketball, but it's for football and every other sport. So it's a certain pride that you have as a Tiger, a Lady Tiger, or a Lady Panther, or whatnot, to just come out and just show out whenever you come against this, when you come into this rivalry.
Jeanette Jackson picking up her second foul.
Yeah, that was an unnecessary foul. Jeanette Jackson is too important to this game to make silly fouls like that. She has to rely on her teammates in the post to be able to help her out on that.
Miracle Davis shooting. How long does Dawn Brown keep Jeanette Jackson in the lineup with those two personals?
Jeanette Jackson is so important to this game that it really is a gamble, but she is one of those players that you can gamble with. Hopefully she just uses her basketball savviness to make sure that she doesn't get into any more foul trouble, because there's so much time left on the clock.
Hampton Finch with a rebound. Jackson with those two personals will not come out. Maybe two. There is a bit of a Prairie View run going on right now. Three-pointer. Long-range three. Monty Cavs.
Monique Abbs has been doing some great things this year. In the last game that Prairie View had, Monique Abbs had 11 points. So she is really stepping up and showing who she is as a player and contributing in her way on this team. And this game is about runs. Basketball is about who has the larger runs and the most amount of time. And so both teams need to be stay locked in and stay focused.
Rosa with it at the timeline. Over Vines and down with the rebound, Cheadle. Davis got in the paint, nobody to toss to out front. That was the direction she was looking. Three-pointer fired by Sydney. She launched an air ball. 7:32 left to play in the first half. This half is going quickly. 22-16. Lady Tigers lead it.
Prairie View A&M University is about the students. Students don't just come here. Prairie View A&M University is about the students. Students don't just come here for the education. They come for the faculty, for the creativity, the camaraderie, an excellent standard of living, and the school spirit. They come here to gain something profound and to give something back. Students come for the tradition of excellence. This is Prairie View A&M University. Our tradition, your opportunity.
Toyota SWAC Basketball Tournament in Houston, Texas. 5 days of nonstop action, and it all goes down. March 10th through the 14th, the SWAC is driven by passion and motivated by pride. Because in the SWAC, history will be made. We do it for the love of the game. Visit www.swachoops.org.
Action resumes. Texas Southern. Shot missed inside, out, and off the fingertips of Caitlin Parks, a 6'4 junior from Barstow, California, put into the lineup. Jeanette Jackson already with 11 of the 16 Prairie View A&M points. I feel fairly secure saying she's going to have her 12th 20-point game tonight.
Yes, it's definitely projected. But the problem is that she is the only one scoring. You have two other players who have contributed. But in order for them to be successful tonight, they have to have at least three players in double digits.
Out of bounds, trying to crawl her way for it was Alexis Parker. Just couldn't catch up with that round ball. The elusive thing rolls out of bounds, and Texas Southern will have it.
Rob, this game is always so intense, and the pressure of the players on the court, they hear the fans, they hear the coaches, they hear their team. They probably cannot hear their coaches, but they have to keep their composure no matter what.
Sophus fouled as she got into the paint, and it was Alexis Parker committing the personal. That is the fifth now on Prairie View.
Dominisha Sophus, which is her name, she has been such a great contributor to the team this year. She's coming from Chipola, a college out in Georgia, one of the top-ranked JUCOs in the country. And what she has been to TSU this year is incredible, remarkable. She's been impactful on scoring. She rebounds. She's just a tough player. Coach says that she's aggressive on and off the court, but it benefits them most when she's on the court.
Texas Southern to steal the points from Sydney.
And that started with Dominisha Sophus. With her deflection, her teammate was able to get the ball and score.
Players thought a timeout had been called. The officials summoning back Tigers and Panthers. Nobody called the timeout.
Another great thing about Dominisha Sophus is she's tied with one of her teammates, Alexis Johnson, for a sixth place in the conference in steals. You that get shows steals. You how active they are.
And if you get the steals, you create opportunities for your offense. There is a foul.
Exactly.
Parker bringing it inside, got popped.
Alexis Parker, that's that player we were talking about, that when she's in double digits, Prairie View is winning. She needs to get her groove tonight, but that that strong penetration to the basket is a great start.
Puts Prairie View into the bonus for the remainder of the half.
Alexis Parker, she's a sophomore out of Savannah, Georgia, averaging 55% from the free throw line.
Thus far tonight, those that don't average that particularly well doing well, and those that average well not doing so well at the line.
One thing that's interesting is Texas Southern is pressing Prairie View, even though they're up. They're putting that pressure on, and they're not letting up.
Davis whips it into the paint, the one hand off the glass and rim. It won't drop in for Morgan Simmons. Jackson from way out front misses on the three. Roser's got it, gives another opportunity to the Lady Panthers. And Simmons will haul it in for Texas Southern. .536 left to play here in the first half. Where has the first half gone?
It's such an intense game that it seems like it's going by so fast. They say time flies when you're having fun. We're having fun.
I think they are too, but it's a little more pressurized than our fun, I guess.
Yeah, it's a lot more pressure, especially on Prairie View. Coming off of a loss, playing on the road, it's important for them to refocus and to stay focused during this game. Texas Southern, one thing I love about them, talking to them earlier, they don't take anything for granted. They're looking to play them harder than they've played even in the regular season.
Abs was trying to get around, and now a walk is called, trying to get around Tony Cheadle. Cheadle got the steal, but then traveled with it.
Yeah, she took a couple of extra steps.
Here comes Alexis Parker from the sidelines. Abs will come out. Jackson, nifty move, right, went left, got the bucket, got fouled, hit the hardwood solidly, and says, give me a minute.
Jeanette Jackson doing what she does best, taking her time getting up. She takes a lot of impact during the games, and she never lets up.
Prairie View came in last night. Got to practice in. Ouch. That I can see why it would be slow getting up for Jeanette Jackson.
Yeah, that looked like it hurt really bad. She may be still collecting herself.
But the Lady Panthers, as a matter of fact, last night was full of basketball. You had the Lady Panthers come in for a shoot-around. You had the men's teams for both Prairie View and Texas Southern here last night. Jackson, maybe still a little rattled, couldn't get it and turn it into a three-point play, just settled for the two.
Jeanette Jackson, also known as JJ, is doing a lot. She's working hard on the offensive and on the defensive end.
Vines back out to Cheadle. Davis will fire the three. Brooks back into the lineup, tipped it over to Roser. Into the paint. What a pass. That's why she's the assist leader for the team and near the top of the SWAC as well. So not just scoring from Jackson, but a nifty pass, and Brooks gets two and foul.
Jeanette Jackson is looking for that. She's looking for that cutter to go to the basket to make her job easier. So they, if like Samaya Brooks, she found a semi-open spot. Jeanette Jackson got it to her, and she finished. That is the way they're going to chip away at this block and get back into this game. And keep staying in this game.
Let's keep it right here. It is a 30-second timeout. 4 minutes, 37 seconds left to play in the half. Brooks going to the line with an opportunity to make a three-point game, a two-point game. Prairie View didn't panic. They got down by double digits early. It was a 17-7 game, then a 19-9 game. But they've just slowly, methodically narrowed that gap.
Well, there's a lot of time on the clock. So if I was their coach, I'd be saying, keep your composure. Do what you know how to do. Practice the way you've been practicing, because they've been having great practices. And let the chips fall where they may. And that's exactly what's happening. Texas Southern had their run early on. Now Prairie View is doing their thing.
By the way, when you leave the house, doesn't mean you got to leave the game or the SWAC behind. You can check out SWAC on the go. The mobile app is available for Android, for the iPhones. Everything SWAC is on the mobile app, so check it out.
I have it on my phone, and I love it.
Keeps you in touch.
Yeah, it's so convenient. Instead of going to the website, having to find my way around, there it is. In a couple of clicks, I have everything I need.
Brooks will head to the stripe, try to make it a bucket ball game after being fouled. Jackson the assist. And she's been doing the bulk of the scoring thus far, but Brooks will go to the line trying to cap off a three-point play.
Shamaya Brooks, she's a 6'4 junior from West Point, Georgia. Her third year here at Prairie View. She's averaging 60% from the free throw line. The great thing I love about Shamaya Brooks is every year she improves. She gets better and better. When she first came, she was a little soft and really couldn't find her positioning in the post. Now people are looking out for Shamaya Brooks.
Surface to Sydney Cheadle. Count the bucket for Ferguson.
Ferguson is really making her presence known in the post, fighting on offense and on defense. She came ready to play tonight.
Jackson looks back. Sophus wanted to take an opportunity to benefit from the look back to the coach. Reached in to get the steal, but Jackson turned around before Sophus could take off with it.
You have the battle of the big girls in the post. Shamaya Brooks. She's going head-to-head.
Sophus to Davis, and the offensive is Sophus ran into Jeanette Jackson. For just a moment, when the whistle was blown, there was a big, deep breath taken by the Lady Panthers. And then a sigh of relief when the foul was not on Jackson. That would have been her third. So she absorbed the offensive. 3:36 left to play. Half number one.
Started my Camry. Went to the auction. Won a storage locker. Found an old guitar. Tracked down the previous owner. Reunited them. Hit the jackpot.
The bold new Camry. One bold choice leads to another. Toyota, let's go places.
Toyota SWAC Basketball Tournament in Houston, Texas. 5 days of nonstop action, and it all goes down. March 10th through the 14th, the SWAC is driven by passion and motivated by pride. Because in the SWAC, history will be made. We do it for the love of the game. Visit www.swachoops.org.
27-22 advantage, Texas Southern on top of the Lady Panthers of Prairie View A&M, but they have fought from a 10-point deficit, sliced it to three, and it's grown back to five for Texas Southern. Looking at the stats handed to us, Jeanette Jackson still on a tear. 13 points now in the ball game for Jackson.
Once again, only two other players have scored besides her. So those scorers on Prairie View really need to pick it up.
Stevens with a pull-up J. Short corner, too strong. Ferguson will get rid of it to Sydney. Sophus looked like she wanted the three, then decided to toss inside to Ferguson, tipped away by Stevens. Alexis Parker for two.
It looked like she wanted to pass it for a second and realized how open she was and took the shot.
Sydney back out front to Davis. Sophus, top of the key. Wide left, Cheadle's got it, puts it in.
Prairie View cannot afford easy buckets like that. They have to find the defender, put a body in, box out.
Davis to Sophus. Got a battle going on inside. Cheadle. Consecutive trips, Cheadle has scored.
Tony Cheadle has really contributed greatly to this team this year. She adds that extra spark of energy that they need and produces whenever they need a basket.
Roser. And it is Sophus that comes up with a loose ball.
You can tell Prairie View is missing the presence of Shamaya Brooks on the inside. She leads the conference in offensive rebounding, and that's what they need right now. They need to get that second chance opportunity to score.
Contact. No whistle blown, and you got a bucket for Ashley Ferguson.
Ashley Ferguson is showing up and showing out tonight. It is a battle of the bigs on the inside, and she is taking no prisoners. She usually averages 6 points per game, but right now she's at 10, and she has no signs of letting up.
Jackson trying to get over to Hampton Finch. Davis, like a cornerback, ran it, picked it off, and goes the other way. Off the glass, bucket's good, and fouled, and going to the stripe is Monica Davis.
Miracle Davis is so fast. I mean, she just went. She grabbed the rebound and beat everyone else back. There she goes, using that speed and using that strength to finish on this end. Alexis Parker was looking for that charge, but I don't think her feet were quite set yet. Miracle Davis did well last time they played Prairie View as well. She had 8 rebounds, 4 steals, 4 assists. Looks like she's adding some points to that.
And speaking of steals, Sydney with one. And there was a timeout. It is a 30-second timeout. All of a sudden, a game that was large, the double-digit lead for Texas Southern, narrowed to 3. It's back to double digits again. And the Lady Tigers undaunted by that string of points by Prairie View that got them close.
Right, and they've been down by more. So it's just about them regrouping and stopping the ball. That's the first thing, stopping it in transition. If you don't stop the ball in transition and stop having these turnovers, then the game will continue to go at this pace.
Can you win the game if you are Prairie View A&M with basically it being all wrapped around Jeanette Jackson?
No, it is impossible for any team to win under the leadership of one person. Her teammates really have to step up and help take that energy off, help take that pressure off of her.
.53 seconds left in the half. Texas Southern with the basketball. Dana Jones, a 6'1 junior from Gulfport, in now. Sophus with a pull up. Brooks got in the way, so she said, let me hand it over here to the big lady, Vines, and Vines couldn't get her to drop in either.
That was a great recognition by Dominicia to see Shamaya Brooks and her wingspan coming and pass it off. That's a smart play. She just needs her teammates to finish.
Brooks going to the line.
Brooks at the line again. It's so important to hit these free throws, especially since they've been struggling to score. And that's Shamaya Big Body Brooks averaging 61% from the free throw line.
And Brooks makes both, checking into the lineup. Morgan Simmons. Vines will come out. Prairie View goes to the bench as well. Shea Haynes, the 6-foot freshman from Patterson, Mississippi. She comes in for Prairie View. Sophus driving it down the floor and winds up right in the middle of the hands of the lady that just came into the lineup, and Sydney took it right back.
Dominicia may have been too relaxed on that last play, but the hustle by Brianna Perry, constantly looking for the ball. She is a ball hawk. And getting that back, being patient, getting it back to the guard to set up their play, that's one thing that Texas Southern does very well.
Half over, and at the half, the advantage belonging to Texas Southern. It is a 9-point lead. Well, Jasher has got the coach for Texas Southern, Jonetta Haynes Perry, nearby. So as soon as he traps coach, we will take a break or take a move towards. So let's send it now to Jasher.
All right, coach, double-digit lead at the halftime. Talk about your first half.
I thought we did some good things. We were able to keep Prairie View 1 point, which is good. Our goal is 6 points or less, but we got to be able to capitalize on those different goals.
Jeanette Jackson is already in double figures here in the first half. How do you contain her?
I mean, last game she had 10 points, tonight she had 13. Jeanette's a great player. We just want to make sure we limit her shots and make her take tough shots, low percentage shots versus high percentage shots.
All right, coach, thanks. Good luck in the second half. Thank you.
Okay,
thank you. All right, Rob, thank you. Appreciate it.
All right, thank you so much, Jasher. Halftime, and it's Texas Southern, the home team, on top.
Welcome to Texas Southern University. Our home is Houston. We are a premier urban university with distinctive undergraduate and graduate programs, innovative research, artistic excellence, and athletic tradition. We are building legends. Your future begins at TSU now.
Prairie View A&M University is about the students. Students don't just come here for the education. They come for the faculty, for the creativity, the camaraderie, an excellent standard of living, and the school spirit. They come here to gain something profound and to give something back. Students come for the tradition of excellence. This is Prairie View A&M University. Our tradition, your opportunity.
There are some moments you spend your life preparing for. Not to prove them wrong, but yourself right. So you work harder, drive stronger, and before you know it, you didn't just beat the game.
Who is that?
Don't know, but he's going places.
You changed it.
Hey, son, ready for the interview?
I got this.
Introducing the 2014 Next Generation Corolla. Toyota, let's go places.
In 1920,
six schools came together to form a strong competitive alliance. That strong competitive alliance became the Southwestern Athletic Conference and stretches from the northeast of Alabama to the rolling plains of Texas, from the coastal marshlands of Louisiana to the Mississippi Delta to the foothills of Arkansas. Students of these 10 world-class institutions know the importance of academic achievement along with athletic excellence. We are proud of our past and value our traditions. We will always stand as one. Alabama A&M. Alabama State. Alcorn State. Grambling State. Jackson State. Mississippi Valley State. Prairie View A&M. Southern. Texas Southern. Arkansas Pine Bluff. We are the Southwestern Athletic Conference. Honor the heritage.
H&PE Center on the campus of Texas Southern University. It is halftime. The 9-point lead belongs to the home team. Robert Williamson, Gatte Wederma bringing you the coverage. And Gatte, first half, much of what we anticipated. Prairie View A&M was able to slice that lead, which went, at one point was 10 to 3, that it grew to 11 again. And now it's at 9 at the half. How does Texas Southern maintain the advantage, come away with a win?
The way they maintain is continuing to put the pressure on Prairie View, as well as continuing to maximize off of the turnovers because they've been scoring well in transition, and just keep scoring. I mean, that's the main thing, shutting them down on defense and pulling the ball in the basket.
When we were discussing pregame in Texas Southern, we were talking about Brianna Sidney. Brianna Sidney, not the leading scorer in the first half, but she did some them nicely.
Right, she does things that are not necessarily on the stat sheet, but she gets the deflection, she gets the steal. She's just an all-around player. So as long as she continues to help lead her team, she's doing great. And she averages 11 points, so she's well on her way.
And, you know, we talk about with Brianna, the points scored, the 11, the nearly 12 points per ball game, but there were some very outstanding defensive plays as well from Brittany Sidney that gave other people an opportunity to put points on the board.
Yes, her coach mentioned that the energy that she brings is immaculate, and she's just a great defender, a great offender. She leads the team as far as her energy. When she plays well, everyone else seems to play well. She's been on this team for 3 years and knows what it takes to be a champion. So she's leading her team towards that.
But she wasn't the leading scorer in the first half for Texas Southern.
Right, Ashley Ferguson was. And as a leader, you don't necessarily have to be the leading scorer, but the fact that you can motivate your teammates and get the ball to your teammate and enable them to score is just as good.
Well, what do we look for in the second half from Prairie View? We know what to expect from Texas Southern. What's Prairie View got to do to come from this 9-point deficit?
Prairie View has to not let it get in their head. The game is about runs, like we mentioned earlier, and they need to contribute to scoring. The way you win a basketball game is to score, and the only person who seems to be doing the most of that is Jeanette Jackson, and she needs help because she's getting banged out in the bottom. She's shooting threes, using all her energy, and they need her on the defensive end. So in order for Prairie View to come back and chip away at that block, we need more people to contribute and more people to rebound.
You know what everybody's playing for, right? You know, to get to the SWAC Basketball Conference and then the championship, the Toyota SWAC Basketball Tournament back in Houston. Join us for 5 days of nonstop action at the Toyota Center March 10th through the 14th to see who will be crowned champion. And don't forget, the action goes beyond the rim. Come out for the postgame concerts by 112 and Salt and Pepper. There will be parties, basketball, a career expo, and fun for the whole family. For more information on the tournament and to purchase tickets, visit swachoops.org, or you can go to swachoops.org as well. You're going to the concert, right?
Of course, and I heard that there are some other special guests who I can't mention right now and spoil it, but it's going to be amazing. Not only is it old school, but it's a mixture of the new school as well, is what the SWAC is bringing. So I'm so excited to attend and to get my party on.
It should be exciting. I'll go ahead and stamp it as definitely exciting as the SWAC Basketball Tournament heads back to this part of the country, Houston, Texas, 10 through the 14th. Halftime, Texas Southern up by 9.
Started my Camry, went to the auction, won a storage locker.
found an old guitar. Tracked down the previous owner. Reunited them. Hit the jackpot.
The bold new Camry. One bold choice leads to another. Toyota, let's go places.
Toyota SWAC Basketball Tournament in Houston, Texas. 5 days of nonstop action, and it all goes down. March 10th through the 14th, the SWAC is driven by passion and motivated by pride. Because in the SWAC, history will be made. We do it for the love of the game. Visit www.swachoops.org.
In 1920, six schools came together to form a strong competitive alliance. That strong competitive alliance became the Southwestern Athletic Conference and stretches from the northeast of Alabama to the rolling plains of Texas, from the coastal marshlands of Louisiana to the Mississippi Delta to the foothills of Arkansas. Students of these 10 world-class institutions know the importance of academic achievement along with athletic excellence. We are proud of our past and value our traditions. We will always stand as one. Alabama A&M. Alabama State. Alcorn State. Grambling State. Jackson State. Mississippi Valley State. Prairie View A&M. Southern. Texas Southern. Arkansas Pine Bluff. We are the Southwestern Athletic Conference. Honor the heritage.
Prairie View A&M University is about the students. Students don't just come here for the education. They come for the faculty, for the creativity, the camaraderie, an excellent standard of living, and the school spirit. They come here to gain something profound and to give something back. Students come for the tradition of excellence. This is Prairie View A&M University. Our tradition, your opportunity.
Welcome to Texas Southern University. Our home is Houston. We are a premier urban university with distinctive undergraduate and graduate programs, innovative research, artistic excellence, and athletic tradition. We are building legends. Your future begins at TSU now.
It is halftime, 35-26, the halftime score. February is Black History Month, and we certainly want to recognize some individuals who have renowned themselves from both campuses, Prairie View A&M and Texas Southern. We start with Prairie View A&M, and Charlie Brackens, he played college football at Prairie View from 51 to 55. He was a three-year starter for legendary head football coach Billy Nix and led the Prairie View Panthers to 33 victories in 37 games in the SWAC. He was a big, tall passer at 6'2 and 205 then. I mean, now guys are a lot taller. Brackens drafted by the Green Bay Packers in the 16th round of the 1955 NFL draft, making him the first HBCU alumnus to play quarterback in the NFL. And, of course, from Texas Southern, it is a guy that, well, he's everywhere these days. That's Michael Strahan, inducted into the 2014 NFL Hall of Fame last summer, playing his entire NFL career with the Giants. Strahan played defensive end at Texas Southern and mounted up 41 career sacks. Currently a football analyst on Fox NFL Sunday, serves as a co-host on the television morning talk show Live with Kelly and Michael alongside Kelly Ripa. He's everywhere these days and certainly has done Texas Southern proud.
Yes, these guys have contributed so greatly and makes us really proud to celebrate them during this time. I mean, the contribution that they've made and the players who look up to them and are motivated and inspired by them is just wonderful, because after them, we've had series of players come out of the SWAC and go on to play professional basketball. I mean, professional basketball, football, baseball, every sport, and these are some of the trailblazers.
Well, we're talking about basketball. Let's go ahead and look at those conference standings again, by the way, because this game impacts the standings. Texas Southern atop the division along with Southern University at 8-1, but there you see Prairie View just a game back. That makes this game so vitally important for Prairie View.
Prairie View can really shake things up if they win this game. It takes an intense focus to pull that together, but it's definitely possible. And if Texas Southern wins this game, it just solidifies them even more as that number one seed.
And, of course, the tournament coming up, 10th through the 14th. We're about set for second half action, a couple of minutes away. And you've already discussed the need for what Texas Southern's got to do to maintain the advantage, what Prairie View's got to do to get back into the ball game. But when you talk about Jeanette Jackson, she's already done everything she needed to do in the first half. I mean, she's just about everything scoring-wise. She's popping out the assists. She's still going to have the big half in the second half as well, correct?
Yes, the game is not over. So her bringing the intensity and her playing the way she has in the first half is wonderful, but there's a whole another half. There's a lot more basketball to be played. So hopefully she can get her teammates to join her and assist her in scoring.
Ritalin Jasher is going to catch up with head coach there at Prairie View A&M. So let's go ahead and turn things over to Jasher Cox. Jasher.
All right, coach, what'd you tell your team at the half?
Go out and play Lady Panther basketball. I think that we can do a good job as far as responding to runs and being patient within the offense. We're looking to rush to get shots, and we're not looking inside to get the ball inside to Shemite.
Jeanette Jackson had a good first half. How do you keep her in rhythm?
Well, she's a player that's going to always – she's going to find a way to get the job done. So one thing that I can rest assured, knowing that she's a senior with that seniority and being a leader on the floor, she's going to continue to get her shots in.
Thanks, coach. Good luck the rest of the way. Thank you. All right, Rob, thanks.
All right, thank you very much. Jasher, 30 seconds away from the start of the second half. We're back after this on the SWAC Digital Network.
Started my Camry. Went to the auction. Won a storage locker. Found an old guitar. Tracked down the previous owner. Reunited them. Hit the jackpot.
The bold new Camry. One bold choice leads to another. Toyota, let's go places.
Toyota SWAC Basketball Tournament in Houston, Texas. 5 days of nonstop action, and it all goes down. March 10th through the 14th, the SWAC is driven by passion and motivated by pride. Because in the SWAC, history will be made. We do it for the love of the game. Visit www.swachoops.org.
H&P Center. And boy, this place is filling up. I'm looking to one side of the arena. Got a good crowd on hand. And the backside, it's got an even larger crowd on hand. Watching the final 20 minutes of this one of the men's game to come.
Oh, yeah, there's always extra security and extra fire marshals needed because this place is at maximum capacity when Prairie View and Texas Southern play each other.
Well, Jackson doesn't have to foul. She just kind of shouted at Morgan Simmons, and Simmons with a miss. And Jackson to the other side. Foul called on the lady that will put Jackson at the line. And once she arises, we can take a look at the numbers. I believe that is Alexis Johnson.
One thing about Morgan Simmons that Coach Perry mentioned is that it's important for her to finish. She has been leading this team. She has been a great scoring. But one thing, Coach mentioned that she needs to finish around the basket.
We all have those moments.
Oh, I just drew a blank there.
Jackson got her first and second.
Jeanette Jackson making a strong move to the basket, starting off early.
Sarah Williams with it just inside midcourt. Abs defending. Abs didn't get a first half start, but she's on the floor to begin this one. Speaking of on the floor, Jackson wound up on the floor. Nice dish inside. Brooks committing the foul as Morgan Simmons brought it into the paint.
Oh, I think it was a jump ball.
Well, scratch that. I just made the assumption once the whistle blew and Brooks got into the face of the lady in the paint, that being Morgan Simmons, that there would indeed be a foul, but nothing doing. Johnson off on the three. Abs. Stolen away by Davis.
That's one thing that Purview struggled with in the first half is those turnovers, because those turnovers caused TSU to maximize off those turnovers and scored in transition. So they need to watch that.
Over the outstretched fingertips of Brooke Simmons for two. Abs rolled it off the ankle and then right into the ankles of her head coach, Dawn Brown. If you're going to roll it off her ankles, I'd pick anybody but head coach to roll it into.
To look up and see those eyes looking back down on you, I'm sure it's an intimidating thing, but she needs to get it back. That's her second turnover in a row. She needs to take care of the ball because they're already down.
Johnson with a miss. Simmons, the follow-up and the foul.
Like I mentioned earlier, Coach Perry, she had great things to say about senior Morgan Simmons. She works hard every day in practice. Her effort is great, and she needs to finish. But she says she knows how to capitalize on different opportunities, and right there she did. When she plays with confidence, she is at her best.
Largest lead of the game for Texas Southern, the 12-point advantage. Still lots of time to go, though. There has been one ever so brief Prairie View lead as the three-pointer is in and out for Parker. That was when Jackson got fouled, hit the free throw, and gave Prairie View A&M the one-point advantage. That is the only Lady Panther lead to the game thus far.
Yes, that was a great assist by Sarah Williams, recognizing Brianna Sidney on the left side, penetrating to the right to get that spacing and handing it back to her.
Blocked by Johnson. Jackson able to get it back, then lost it. Sidney's got it. Down the floor as Johnson takes the pass, got hammered, winds up on the hardwood.
Texas Southern's intensity is just higher right now. They're more fired up. They're more excited. Prairie View needs to get there to match their energy, or they'll wind up in a larger deficit.
Prairie View A&M sensing the need to regroup. Ask for the timeout. 42-28, Texas Southern.
Started my Camry. Went to the auction. Won a storage locker. Found an old guitar. Tracked down the previous owner. Reunited them. Hit the jackpot.
The bold new Camry. One bold choice leads to another. Toyota, let's go places.
Toyota SWAC Basketball Tournament in Houston, Texas. 5 days of nonstop action, and it all goes down. March 10th through the 14th, the SWAC is driven by passion and motivated by pride. Because in the SWAC, history will be made. We do it for the love of the game. Visit www.swachoops.org.
Fans, the 2015 SWAC Men's and Women's Indoor Track and Field Championships will be held the 21st and 22nd of this month at the Birmingham Crossplex. Finals to be carried live right here on the SWAC Digital Network. Visit SWAC.org for more information. Got to talk about Larissa Scott being out. Only played in 5 games this year. She played on those 3 consecutive SWAC championships. How bad does it hurt the Panthers not to have her in the lineup.
They are really missing her presence on the inside. Shamiah Brooks is inside, and she's rebounding. But Larissa Scott added so much to Prairie View's team. This year alone, she averaged in the games that she did play 7 rebounds. And recently, she just had shoulder surgery. So we're all wishing her the best and a speedy recovery on that. But her presence is definitely missed because she can rebound those balls that Prairie View was lacking and TSU was maximizing on.
Jackson to the timeline out front.
Larissa was also projected as the SWAC Defensive Player of the Year. That shows how much of an impact she has in this conference.
Parker gets the Lady Panthers to within 12.
That Alexis Parker, we mentioned earlier that when she scores in double digits, Prairie View wins. She needs to start scoring. Get that rhythm going.
Brooks got the block, swatted it out front. Sydney able to pick up the loose ball.
Shamiah Brooks makes it look so easy. She has 36 blocks and is the second best in the SWAC. Had a season high the second game of the season against Texas A&M, who is ranked number 7 in the country.
Hand it over to Abs, who will bring it out of the corner. There was an offensive, and that might have been on Jackson. Let's see if she hooked a defender. Let's see what the official says. Nope, it was Brooks, not Jackson. Brooks called with a foul. It was in the vicinity of Jackson. Thought for a moment she was going to get rung up, but the official spotted Brooks doing the hook.
I know Coach is relieved about that. With Jeanette Jackson being the core of their offense right now, she does not need any more fouls.
Over to Sydney, out front it goes to Davis. Sheetal wanted it at the low post. Instead, Sophus will work it to the other side of the key. Into Cheadle. Got to take a major detour to get around Brooks. Loose ball picked up by Parker. Jackson back over to Parker, and Parker couldn't get the roll. Sophus with the elbow over to Cheadle. Three-pointer, it is off its mark from Sophus. Avs wide open underneath. That's an easy two for Alexis Parker.
That is a great finish by Alexis Parker, but it started with Shamiah Brooks. And being that presence in there, getting that ball, securing it, and getting it started allowed her team's offense to open up. That's what needs to continue to happen in order for Prairie View to chip away at this 10-point deficit.
Tigers calling the timeout. It is a full timeout. So why don't we take the 60-second break as well. 15:04 to play. It's a 10-point game.
Toyota SWAC Basketball Tournament in Houston, Texas. 5 days of nonstop action, and it all goes down March 10th through the 14th. The SWAC is driven by passion and motivated by pride, because in the SWAC, history will be made. We do it for the love of the game. Visit www.swachoops.org.
SWAC Digital Network spending a Saturday night in Houston, and tonight's coverage of this broadcast brought to you by Toyota. Also brought to you by the Home Depot. We all are sporting great-looking new SWAC wear, compliments of Russell Athletics. And, of course, Nike making coverage possible, too. And our thanks to Coca-Cola for their sponsorship of the SWAC Digital Network in Houston, Texas. Texas Southern University. Finals in other games being played. Jackson State has beaten Alcorn 65-41. Alabama State, a 62-54 winner over the University of Arkansas in Pine Bluff. Southern defeating Grambling 80-52, and Alabama A&M over Mississippi Valley State 71-51. And some of those teams we will get to see on Monday as Cheadle brings it inside. Got it back and missed a second time, too. We, of course, will be in Pine Bluff, Arkansas a week from Monday as Alcorn State comes to town. Panthers got into a wee bit of a jam on the far sidelines and asked for the timeout.
Right, that was a great rebound by Lachey Haynes to secure the ball and get it out quickly so that coach can put in her new game plan.
Fans, the 2015 SWAC Men's and Women's Golf Championship takes place on the links of the Bayou at the Oak Wing Golf Club in Alexandria, Louisiana. It happens the 20th through the 22nd. And if golf doesn't suit your fancy, or maybe you need a little more, what about bowling? 2015 SWAC Women's Bowling Championship held at the Bowling International Training and Research Center in Arlington, Texas. And that happens the 20th and 22nd of March. Boy, there's just championships left and right in the SWAC.
Yes. So exciting to see all these great athletes compete.
Prairie View, as close as they have been since that 3-2 lead, was 25-22 with about 9 minutes to play in the first half.
Texas Southern is not letting up. They're at home. They play great at home. They have a chip on their shoulder. This game is a rematch of the 2014 SWAC Tournament Championship game in which Prairie View defeated Texas Southern 63-58. So they have a chip on their shoulder and they have something to prove, especially being their only loss in conference.
Well, thus far they're proving it. Cheadle going to the stripe. I mentioned you played in this series. How much more difficult? Because you're thinking, okay, it's the same caliber team that you face in Prairie View that you face at Texas Southern. So how much more difficult is it playing on the Texas Southern hardwood?
It's different because the gym is bigger, so the depth perception is off. So if you don't get your shots up, your shots may be off. You have fans screaming at you and booing you who you typically wouldn't hear. So all that combined, and then the jitters of it being such a huge game, it is all, you know, what the adds pressure. But that's what this game is about. This game is about mental toughness and pressure.
Abs with a miss. Haynes trying to put it back in and got fouled. H&PE Center is the only place that I've been to as we take another look at the foul after the miss by Abs.
Another great rebound by Lachey Haynes, who has only shot 4 free throws this whole season and has made all 4, so she is 100% from the line.
But you know, here at Texas Southern, they've got a song they sing when someone fouls out, so it's rare that you look forward to somebody fouling out, but you know, you're kind of looking forward to that.
Yeah, they're very animated here, and it's always some form of entertainment on any inch of the gym that you see. It's so exciting to even just be here, not even only as a player, but as a spectator. I think she keeps her perfect record, 100% from the free throw line.
And gets her team to within 10. Miracle Davis in the lineup. Over goes to Sophus for 3.
That is a mistake that you cannot afford. Knowing the types of players that Texas Southern has, knowing that they score, shoot three-point players, you should always see where your player is.
Largest lead of the ball game for Texas Southern. Jackson, who scored most of her points in the first half, stepped on the arc to get the long 2.
And the same thing happened on Prairie View's offensive end. Texas Southern took their eyes off of Jeanette Jackson for a second, and it was over.
Cheadle with a 3-point miss. It is retrieved by Haynes. Jackson Got tripped up a bit. Sofas may be the guilty party. It is Sofas.
Jeanette Jackson has seen the floor a lot tonight, but she is just so tough. Hesitating, crossing over, and going up for the shot.
Non-shooting foul. Hampton Finch out front to Jackson. Jackson now with 17. Sofas not particularly pleased with a foul. Officials calling the hand check a lot quicker, and if Sofas does a lot of conversing with the official, you might see, you know, what is it, when the index finger meets the underside of the other hand's palm from the official.
As a player, you have to make sure that you don't contribute negatively to the game and make sure that you stay on top of your emotions. You have to keep your cool, whether you think it's a good or a bad call. You don't want to have such an impactful player be out at such a critical time in the game.
Roser stepping in before releasing the basketball. Turnovers, got it back over to Texas Southern. Sydney off on the three-point try. Cheadle climbing up on the back of Roser to try to get the rebound.
These ladies are just itching for the rebound, but you have to make sure that you be careful and not foul. Ashley Ferguson, she's back in the game. She came off the bench earlier this year after an injury, and her minutes have continuously gone up from 8 minutes to 10 to 12. Coach is trying to keep her in for 20 minutes, and she also has a good shooting percentage.
Brooks getting the two. Williams from one side of the key to the other. Davis over to Cheadle, and it goes to Ferguson. Ferguson, only double-digit Texan Southern score, as the three-pointer is launched by Sarah Williams.
Sarah Williams is one of those players that she continues to show up each night as well. She does her part. When she needs to knock down a shot, she will. If she needs to make the pass in order to get her teammate available, she does that as well. She's been contributing so much tonight.
Abs tries the three. Brooks, she got the putback.
Brooke and Parker are assisting Jeanette Jackson in the scoring and enabling them to cut the lead, but Texas Southern is not going out without a fight.
And it goes to Cheadle, ran into Brooks, and they say a blocking foul on Brooks, and Brooks turned around as if to say, I can't believe it, which, gotta admit, I thought she was there, and actually Cheadle initiated the contact, but that's not how the official saw it.
Right, and it's so hard as a post player who is strong and aggressive. No matter if your body is in position, it's hard to tell whether you're still moving or not. And Cheadle sure met Shania Brooks just now.
11:27 to play. Texas Southern by 10.
Prairie View A&M University is about the students. Students don't just come here for the education. They come for the faculty, for the creativity, the camaraderie, an excellent standard of living, and the school spirit. They come here to gain something profound and to give something back. Students come for the tradition of excellence. This is Prairie View A&M University. Our tradition, your opportunity.
Welcome to Texas Southern University. Our home is Houston. We are a premier urban university with distinctive undergraduate and graduate programs, innovative research, artistic excellence, and athletic tradition. We are building legends. Your future begins at TSU now.
couple of double-digit scores from Prairie View. It is Jackson with 17 and now Brooks with 10. And actually, Brooks has very quietly worked herself into a position to get a double-double with 9 rebounds. Meanwhile, the lone double-digit score for Texas Southern is Ferguson with 10, but it's a very balanced scoring attack for the Lady Tigers.
Leshemeyer Brooks, she does it quietly, but she makes her presence known down there.
Vines reaching over Brooks, got the rebound, then the Brooks defense created the Vines walk. Jackson top of the key looking for a 12th 20-point game. Abs too long on the three. Vines with it.
Jeanette Jackson was looking for her teammates to continue moving on offense, and it seemed as if nobody was. So she penetrated and created a shot for her teammate. They have to work with her, though. They have to move. They have to get open because they know that they're putting the pressure defense on Jeanette Jackson.
Brooks got the steal, hands it to Jackson. Jackson 2-on-2 to the glass, 19 now in the game for Jeanette.
She's just incredible.
And Abs got the steal and the quick put back.
Prairie View is really turning up the defense in order to create their offense, and that's what their coach was asking.
Prairie View trying to make a run. Stevens trying to get the steal for Miracle Davis and fouled her.
And that's just a hustle foul. She just has to make sure she controls her body, but that's the type of intensity that Prairie View needs right now.
Stevens coming out of the lineup. Alexis Parker is put back in. Williams taking the inbounds from Davis. Sydney will go to the stripe. Cheadle goes to the hoop. Vines couldn't get the put back. Brooks had it, lost it. Sydney picks it up.
And that's a result of Prairie View not boxing out, not finding their player and putting a body on them. When you don't do that, then you leave it to be anybody's ball.
Vines kicks it out of the low post, and Brooks apparently picked up another foul.
Texas Southern is being very smart. They see Ashley Ferguson on the inside posting up, asking for it. That's when you give it to her, and she opens it up for someone else and draws the foul. That's wonderful.
Lashae Haynes checking into the lineup as Brooks will go out. Vines will shoot.
That's Kiana Vines. She is a 67% three-throw shooter.
Front end of the 1-1 earns the bonus for Vines. Stay up to date on all things SWAC and follow us on Twitter, Facebook, Instagram, and Vine, all by searching the username TheSWAC. Perfect trip to the stripe for Vine. Jackson working the dribble all the while. Dawn Brown is barking out instructions. Count the bucket.
Jeanette Jackson once again at her best. Coach mentioned that she will do what she has to do, and it's the rest of the team that needs to catch up with her. And she is showing us how to get it done.
Officials say it's off Prairie View and out. It is up and in for Miracle Davis.
Jeanette Jackson just scored her 23rd point, making that 12
ball games this year.
That's amazing.
Tries the three, too strong. Vines had it, lost it, battled to get it back, picked up near the baseline by Davis. Williams working the dribble to one side of the floor, throws to the other. Cheadle gave it the inside look. One second showing on the shot clock when Davis got the two.
Miracle Davis is really showing out tonight. She's working on the offensive end. She has 9 points now. She has been contributing on defense, being aggressive. That's exactly what Coach Perry expects from her.
Cheadle committing the foul. It's got Hampton Finch shooting. Both teams now in the bonus. Abs comes out. Roser will come in for Prairie View.
And that is Asha Hampton Finch, hailing from San Antonio, Texas. She's a senior this year. Hampton Finch has been contributing greatly to this team. She averages 67% from the free throw line.
How late, if you're Prairie View, can you wait to begin that run? You're running out of time, 8 minutes, 3 seconds to play.
Yeah, there's no time like now. In order to chip away at any point deficit, you need to start at the earliest time possible. And Coach Brown has recognized that and is putting the pressure on Texas Southern.
Diamondisha Sophus back into the lineup for Texas Southern. Save Simmons for two.
Oh, wow. This team passes the ball so much. It seems like they overpass at time. But with that hustle that they have and finding the open player, you allow for great things like that to happen, a open shot under the basket.
Simmons got the points, but it was Dana Jones who saved it from going out and got it to Simmons. Haynes with a miss.
That is a great hustle by Texas Southern.
Hampton Finch from the line.
Hampton Finch, that's her all day. That is her area. When she gets the ball there and she shoots, she's most likely going to make it. It's just about getting the ball inside to her.
Into the corner it goes to Sydney. Fires the three. It's an air ball. On the receiving end is Alexis Parker. Roser from the short corner goes to Jackson, steps behind the line, misses on the three. Right now it is a 5-on-4 because Parker is slow getting to the other end of the floor.
One thing that Texas Southern is doing a great job of is controlling the tempo of this game. They are not allowing Prairie View's aggressive defense to pressure them.
Dana Jones charged with the offensive.
That was a great move. She just had to go up instead of forward, and she continued forward. And when you do that, and the player has their position, that's the charge all day.
6 minute, 15 seconds left in this one. It is a 58-50 game. Prairie View A&M. Hanging in there.
Started my Camry. Went to the auction. Won a storage locker. Found an old guitar. Tracked down the previous owner. Reunited them. hit the jackpot.
The bold new Camry. One bold choice leads to another. Toyota, let's go places.
Toyota SWAC Basketball Tournament in Houston, Texas. 5 days of nonstop action, and it all goes down. March 10th through the 14th, the SWAC is driven by passion and motivated by pride. Because in the SWAC, history will be made. We do it for the love of the game. Visit www.swachoops.org.
Prairie View A&M, Texas Southern. Prairie View enters the contest having its five-game win streak snapped by Alabama State. For the last time, obviously, they met these two teams. It was a 63-61 PVAMU win. Hampton Finch over to Roser. .23 in the game for Jackson, 10 for Brooks. The two double-digit scores as Jackson tries for 25. Brooks getting the rebound. And that, by the way, is rebound number 10. And now there's another foul.
What you cannot do is do something positive on the court with an offensive rebound and then talk to the ref because they missed the call. This is basketball. Calls may be missed, but you have to make sure you keep your composure, keep your hair cool. The game is too close.
Taking a look at Brooks in the paint. She was the one the foul was called on, I believe. Got the rebound. And it was a technical. And apparently, oh, that's foul number 5. So that means the foul out song is coming.
Wow.
She didn't get the double-double, though. Got her 10th rebound before fouling out. Finishes with 10 rebounds, 10 points.
She did, and that changes a lot of things now because Shamaya was the leading rebounder, and she created that presence on the inside that allowed Texas Southern, that pulled away Texas Southern's post. Without her, they really need someone to step up in there, be aggressive, and pull down those rebounds, or else this can get really ugly.
And I'm assuming, and this is just an assumption, that Brooks felt like she got fouled and she'd been called for 4 fouls earlier and just was taken out of frustration on the fact that no foul was called.
Right, no matter what you feel, you have to keep that composure because now they need her and there's nothing she can do.
Lead goes back to 10. Your leading rebounder and shot blocker is out, done with for the remainder of the day. And leaves on a technical foul, which is unusual. And really, it's kind of a double effect from the standpoint of losing your composure because you get tossed on a technical. You pick up your 5th foul on a technical.
Yeah, the irony. But Prairie View really needs to do what they can on the inside.
Don't know that you'd see a better pass. Johnson just put it where only Vines could get it. And then Vines got fouled. Andrew Roberts doing some cosmetics. You know, Andrew is just Mr. Do-It-All here at Texas Southern. Got us a lot of information on the Tigers, and we appreciate so much the hospitality. By the way, got to mention this Bennett, who got me some boudin.
Boudin, that was your first time having boudin?
Actually, it's going to be the second. I've saved it. Haven't participated in it yet. Haven't indulged.
I don't eat pork, but the chicken boudin is fairly good.
1 for 2 goes Vines. Stevens to bring it in from the near sidelines. Time running out on the Prairie View squad. Not a time yet to panic, but the anxiety's growing, down by 11 with 5:18 to go.
The anxiety is surely growing, but the composure is what's needed here. And as long as she keeps that, they'll be fine.
timeout, Prairie View. It is a 30-second timeout. Let's keep it right here as the house continues to get full of people getting ready for the nightcap of the Twin Bill. Of course, that's the men of Prairie View A&M and the men from Texas Southern in the game that follows. Van Petaway will step in to provide the color analysis. Of course, Gate Wedema here in the ladies' game. And we're all in Pine Bluff, Arkansas, a week from Monday as Alcorn takes on the Golden Lions of UAPB. And we'll have the coverage for you right here on the SWAC Digital Network. Fans, come out and support your favorite SWAC school in the 2015 SWAC Men's and Women's Outdoor Track and Field Championships held at Lewis Cruz Stadium on the campus of Alabama A&M, April 24th through the 26th. Be there.
Or be square.
Roser from the baseline, way out front to Stevens.
Looks like she almost got that second 5-second call.
Stevens trying to get the no-look into Hampton Finch. Problem was, Hampton Finch wasn't looking either.
You have to take care of the ball, and you have to communicate. Basketball is about communication, especially at a time like this where you're down. You can't afford to really make those same mistakes that you could in the beginning of the game.
Sophus for two.
And Dominisha Sophus is so quick. The way she got to the basket in one dribble.
Jeanette Jackson saying, you know what, I guess I'm going to have to do everything myself.
And that's why she's this WAC leading scorer. Not to mention also first on the team in assists, second in the SWAC.
Southern has already won tonight, 80-52 over Grambling State, so Texas Southern's got a win to stay in line with Southern University as Sophus gets the bucket.
Dominisha Sophus, Miss Nini, has scored in double figures 9 times this season, but has been held under that for the last 6 games. Last time she scored over 10 points was against Prairie View last month, where she scored 15 points. So she likes to show up against Prairie View. And she leads the SWAC also in assists with 3.9, which we can see why.
Simmons going to her knees, able to get rid of the basketball over to Sophus. Thrown away by Johnson. 3:28 to play. And we are down to the last media timeout. 65-52, Texas Southern.
Prairie View A&M University is about the students. Students don't just come here for the education. They come for the faculty, for the creativity, the camaraderie, an excellent standard of living, and the school spirit. They come here to gain something profound and to give something back. Students come for the tradition of excellence. This is Prairie View A&M University. Our tradition, your opportunity.
Welcome to Texas Southern University. Our home is Houston. We are a premier urban university with distinctive undergraduate and graduate programs, innovative research, artistic excellence, and athletic tradition. We are building legends. Your future begins at TSU now.
House is getting full. I think this place seats about 8. And we've got a nice crowd on hand for this one, including the commissioner of the Southwestern Athletic Conference, Stuart Sharp, has taken in tonight's game as well.
Preparing for the SWAC tournament that will also be here in Houston.
10th through the 14th.
Yes.
3 minutes, 28 seconds left to play. University, that is from Prairie View A&M, has got to get some points to the board. And they will get to do it with the clock stopped as the foul is committed by Alexis Johnson.
Alexis Johnson just has so much energy. When she sees the ball, she wants to jump up there and get it. And sometimes she draws the foul.
Here's where you got to make free throws, too. You're down by 13. The clock has stopped. You got to score without that clock running.
Yes, free throws matter so much. If the game came down to free throws, Prairie View would be ahead. They rank higher in their free throw percentage. But you have to make sure you show up and hit those shots.
And Haynes, when she needed two, got neither. Simmons back over to Davis, and now Texas Southern will take as much of the 30 as they can. Shot was up with four. Simmons gets it back over to Sydney. Trying to get it to Davis. Haynes touched it while it went out. Sydney handling it from the baseline. First game of the doubleheader, the men's basketball game, about 20 minutes after this one wraps up. And, of course, it's here, too, on the SWAC Digital Network.
That's going to be such a good game with the Texas Southern men and women in first place. And such a huge rivalry. It's going to be exciting.
Sydney with a miss, but it got the rims, reset the shot clock, and Sophus will run some more time off that clock. Clock is now definitely a Lady Tiger ally.
We spoke earlier about how Texas Southern does a great job of controlling the pace of the game, and this is a prime example. They will run it down to the very end and find their open player and take a shot.
Sophus shoots with four, but again an offensive rebound. So if you are Texas Southern, you've had an opportunity to run better than a minute off the clock, and finally Hampton Finch just has to foul Sophus.
Right, they're being real smart about it. They're not trying to force anything. They're not trying to make plays out of thin air. What they're trying to do is run this clock down, maintain this league, and get that victory for tonight.
Both teams now into the double bonus. Sophus will shoot. Has an opportunity to become one of the double-digit scorers in this one if she gets both.
And she's been playing great tonight. She's been effective on defense, causing Prairie View to turn over. And she is in her hometown, so her family is here tonight, Houston, Texas.
Timeout on the floor, a minute 48 left to play. Texas Southern enjoying the 66-52 advantage. Is that an insurmountable lead? It's a 14-point lead. There's 1 minute 48 seconds to play. That's going to be tough.
There are people who have come back from this sort of deficit, but Prairie View would have to bring the intensity and turn it up, score the ball. That's the main thing that they're missing. Jeanette Jackson, when she's not scoring and no one else really is scoring.
Baseball fans, don't forget to support the 2015 SWAC Baseball Tournament. It's the 13th through 17th in New Orleans. And if softball's your fancy, it happens in May as well. Happens in Decatur, Alabama, at Wilson Morgan Park, May 6th through 9th. Come out and show your support for your favorite SWAC schools, whether it be softball or baseball. It all happens in May. Again, you've already got winners in ladies basketball tonight. Jackson State over Alcorn, Alabama State defeating Arkansas Pine Bluff. Southern over Grambling, and Alabama A&M has defeated Mississippi Valley State. Did a game on, I believe it was Thursday night, where a team overcame a 14-point deficit in 2 minutes and 27 seconds.
See, it can be done. It can be done, but you just have to score the ball.
Got a little less than 227, though. But you're right. Got the three-point play. You've got the three-point shot. Sophus now with double digits. And the lead is as big as it has been for Texas Southern at 15. And stolen away. That may have just sealed it as Alexis Johnson comes away with it.
That was a late pass. And she allowed the defense to get her flustered and create that turnover. And Texas Southern, as they have been doing in these final minutes, is controlling the tempo of this game.
Sophus, top of the key, fires and hits the three.
Wow, great shot. She has shown herself to be a great player in the SWAC this year.
Jackson adding to the total.
And that Jackson, she's not going to bow down. She will play to the last second, and if you gave her an extra 2 minutes, she still would play. Love the intensity.
Down to the final 45 seconds of the ball game. Texas Southern will improve to 9-1 on the year and stay atop the SWAC. On the ladies' side is Sophus, misses, and then it's swatted away out of bounds by Johnson. But Texas Southern will hang with Southern University atop the division.
And I believe that's Johnson's fifth foul.
So two foul out. Brooks fouls out for Prairie View A&M. Leaving the floor via the fouls is Alexis Johnson for Texas Southern. But we don't get the song when one of the home team fouls out.
Not at home. They show support whether you foul out or don't play when you're at home. That's Asha Hampton Finch at the line, where she usually shoots 68%.
Simmons with a rebound off the miss.
That's a strong rebound by Morgan Simmons.
Not a lot of difference between shot and game clock. Texas Southern about to improve to 12-9 on the year. Prairie View will fall to 9-13. Jones.
That was a shot clock, even though it was a great shot. But Prairie View just has to mentally bounce back from this and be able to go into the next game with a fresh mind state, understanding that conference tournament is coming up soon, and it's anybody's ball game. Whoever shows up to play is who will come out on top.
And we have seen on both sides of the SWAC, men's and women's, where you think that one team is, now they're in charge. They're winning games, they're beating powerhouses, and then they get beaten. So, indeed,
exactly,
anybody can do it come tournament time. This one is over. It goes final. And it is a Texas Southern win by 15 as they knock off Prairie View, and the win streak, it stays intact for Texas Southern, but for Prairie View A&M, they've lost two in a row, Alabama State, and now to the Lady Tigers. We come back to close out this one and get ready to move into game number two of our Twin Bill right after we take a break on the SWAC Digital Network.
Started my Camry, went to the auction, won a storage locker, found an old guitar. Tracked down the previous owner. Reunited them. Hit the jackpot.
The bold new Camry. One bold choice leads to another. Toyota, let's go places.
Toyota SWAC Basketball Tournament in Houston, Texas. 5 days of nonstop action, and it all goes down March 10th through the 14th. The SWAC is driven by passion and motivated by pride, because in the SWAC, history will be made. We do it for the love of the game. Visit www.swachoops.org. Toyota SWAC Basketball Tournament in Houston, Texas. 5 days of nonstop action, and it all goes down March 10th through the 14th. The SWAC is driven by passion and motivated by pride, because in the SWAC, history will be made. We do it for the love of the game. Visit www.swachoops.org.
This one has gone final, 70-55, the final score, as the Lady Tigers of Texas Southern have knocked off Prairie View A&M. They get a little revenge. The last loss they suffered this year in conference play was to Prairie View A&M, 63-61, so they got some revenge tonight.
Yes, they did, and they have momentum going into the second half of the conference, and I know they're excited about that. Prairie View, on the other hand, I know they're ready to regroup and see how they can strategize to get back on the up and up.
And with a win, they are still atop the conference. They're tied with Southern University. Southern University has won tonight, but Texas Southern is still atop that conference standing.
With the way they've been playing and the way Coach Perry has been coaching these ladies, if they continue doing this, continue showing up every night and showing what they have, I'm sure that they'll stay on top.
Quick look at the next ladies' game that we do together. That is a week from Monday, Alcorn State taking on the University of Arkansas at Pine Bluff. What do we look for?
We're looking forward to a great game. Pine Bluff always comes, and their coaches are passionate, and they teach them to work hard every day and to bring it every day. So that's going to be a great atmosphere to be in, similar to this.
And it happens a week from Monday, 16th of February. We will be there, Alcorn State and the University of Arkansas at Pine Bluff. Gadi Wadarma, great working with you again. Look forward to about 9 days from now when we meet in Arkansas.
It's always great. The SWAC always shows love, so I'm getting ready for this men's game. This is what's popping right now.
And it should be a dandy. It's coming up next on our twin bill. Gadi Wadarma providing the color analysis. And Van Penaway is coming up for the men's game. Inside the SWAC, it's coming up after the break.